Hello, I'm Detective Kevin Brown of the Baltimore Police Department Public Affairs Section. On this segment of Baltimore Police Beat, we'll be interviewing the Aviation Unit of the Baltimore Police Department, more commonly known as FOXTROT.
The Aviation Unit initially started in 1970. It got off to a rather slow start for financial reasons. It was very new in police work in general. This is one of the first units that picked up and really started running. It was initially employing totally military helicopter pilots, most of which, of course, at that time came out of Vietnam. So they were able to get some very well-qualified, experienced pilots to start the unit off with. And that's how that unit ran until 1998. And the way the history repeats itself, the unit as it came back in 2001, we are again finding ourselves staffed almost entirely with military pilots. Of course, now they haven't come from Vietnam, now they've been from Iraq, Afghanistan, Bosnia, but nearly every one of our pilots has some type of military and even combat training all over the world, which is where they built up their hours before coming to work for Baltimore City Police Department. We have 24 sworn personnel and 3 civilian personnel, which are our 3 maintenance personnel. We're very proud of our maintenance section. We've got 3 mechanics that combined have over 100 years experience in working on turbine-powered helicopters, which is what we operate. So we're real proud of the maintenance personnel that we have, and the rest of the sworn personnel, and of course include the pilots, which are police as well as pilots. We do send them to the academy. The rest of the members are observers, which we seek out people with a high level of street experience, because that's our mission, is to support those officers on the ground, primarily patrol units. Our best observer is somebody that's got a lot of patrol experience. We have 4 Eurocopter EC-120s. The particular helicopter that we were seeking out for this mission was one that had a pretty good fuel economy, a low signature as far as the noise goes, and of course something ultra reliable. First and foremost, for safety reasons, we wanted it to be a turbine-powered aircraft. The turbine engine is just much more reliable than a piston-powered aircraft, so you're going to have fewer engine failures, fewer emergency landings, things of that nature. The second most thing that was important to us is keeping the sound level at a nice, reasonably low level that you're not going to disrupt people entirely within the city as you fly over an urban environment. This aircraft at the time was pretty much the quietest aircraft out on the market due to the enclosed tail rotor, which they call a fenestron, and that was designed specifically to keep the sound level lower. It's proven to be a very reliable aircraft for us. We're now over 30,000 hours with this aircraft without incident. We were recognized by the manufacturer for that. 30,000 hours is a lot of airtime in a helicopter without having any incidents at all, particularly with the type of flying that we do. Medevac missions and police missions tend to be a little bit more hazardous than commercial flight from A to B, if you would. We're very happy with the aircraft as far as what we're getting out of it, the fuel consumption, the hours we've gotten out of the aircraft. Very rarely are we not able to fill our full patrol schedule because we're having maintenance issues or something. It's a mechanical instrument. It has lots of moving parts. Obviously, there are times that they have to be taken apart and fixed. That's why we have 4 of them. The primary responsibilities have been the same as they've always been for Foxtrot, which is assisting ground units in the apprehension of criminals. That's mission number one. We have a lot of other things that also get worked into it, and we continue to find new ways to use the aircraft to assist the city in its crime control. Obviously, it's a great tool for doing surveillance. We do photo missions for the crime lab, for state's attorney's office, at times involved with traffic control during major events. We do that in addition to the searching for suspects that we do on a daily basis. That's what the guys enjoy the most. Different mission is nice every once in a while. We do a lot of the homeland security missions. We check the port. Of course, we have several radios. We're monitoring citywide channel, and we're also monitoring the aviation channel. We work very closely with some of the specialized units. This is the Regional Auto Theft Task Force. That's the radio side of it, which is sometimes it's really nice having two observers in there when all the radios are going. Now, we also have a mapping system that in the event that we're trying to call people in on a vehicle that's eluded police, we can give them over the radio exactly what block and intersection that vehicle was at. That makes the whole scenario much safer. The FLIR system, which is for forward-looking infrared, it's more than just light amplification because it does give us vision at night. However, it detects heat as opposed to just amplifying the light. So you have kind of the added benefit. You can have a suspect that is hiding under an object that you could not see with the naked eye or see with the searchlight, but heat will come out of that. Also have the LoJack system for stolen autos. It's the same system that's in a lot of the patrol cars, and that gives us, as simply as an arrow pointing in the direction of the stolen vehicle, as we zero in on it, we get a stronger and stronger signal. We have terrific success with that as well. It's kind of simple, and lots of times almost forget it as terms of equipment, but the searchlight is obviously a terrific tool. And I think a lot of patrolmen will tell you that that's the one they appreciate the most, because when you are down on the street and you're in an area with a low light situation and you're looking for a suspect, you don't know where the suspect is. The helicopter comes overhead with a searchlight that totally illuminates the entire block. It's a comforting feeling for the officer. It greatly enhances his ability to locate the suspect, and it has a psychological effect on the suspect. So it's all wins for us with that, and that's kind of the almost the most simple tool that we have, but we get great use out of it. The best thing that any officer can do with an interest in coming out here is to go out and be the best patrol officer that you possibly can. We draw patrol officers for the most part. On average, I'm going to say we've had them as little as 5 years of experience out here, generally 10 years of experience in patrol work. And since that gives you the most familiarity with the city, that gives you the most familiarity with the operations of the patrol. Of course, you know, when we do post for openings, we'll get as many as 70 officers come out here. And you know, people with real technical backgrounds are very valuable to us as well, considering the mission equipment that we have in the aircraft. As far as being a flight officer, we require 1,400 hours of flight time. And half of that has to be in a turbine aircraft, which kind of eliminates paying your way to getting those many hours. And then that also, about half has to be as a pilot in charge. So that really kind of locks us into aviators that either have a military background or a significant commercial background. My advice to a young officer that wants to come out here and work would be, you know, be the best patrol officer that you can. Since its inception, this unit's had a lot to be proud of. One being one of the first cities and departments in the country to aggressively pursue airborne law enforcement at that level. And all the way through the 70s, 80s, they did outstanding work. Tragically, in 1998, due to an engine failure, there was a fatal crash in Baltimore City, and Flight Officer Barry Wood lost his life in that crash. And all the evidence from the crash scene shows that Barry Wood actually maneuvered the helicopter during impact to put himself taking the brunt of the impact and thus saving the life of aerial observer Mark Keller. Obviously it was devastating to the unit. The unit shut down. We came back up in 2001, and one of the proudest moments of the unit, you had the inaugural flight with the new aircraft, Fox 451, which is dedicated to Barry Wood and has his name on the door, and his wife was here to see the inception of the new unit, and we started back up in 2001. Us being up in the air helps not just the officers on the ground, but all the citizens of Baltimore. Keeps them safe from high-speed pursuits. It keeps the officers safe from things that they can't see. It's a good system. We continue to refine it, and hopefully it'll be getting refined for another 30 or 40 years.